Another video. Hi guys, how are you? This is Joyce, and I am back with another video today. Just some questions. I always have some questions, and I want to see what the answers are going to be, what my guides are going to show me, and I'd like to share it with you. I am doing fantastic. One of my subscribers noticed I was coughing the other night and was wondering, was I sick? No. No, I'm not sick. I'm fine. Although last night's class, numerology class, was just amazing. We had people who had aha moments left and right. People got a really chance to look at themselves and looking at others. So it's been fantastic. We were looking at personality numbers, life path numbers, breaking the birthday downs in Saturn return. So that was a lot of fun. It's an enjoyable class. The energy is just terrific. And also, thank you to the people from the drill class that wrote me and thanked me and stuff like that. I enjoyed that tremendously as well. I got new cards, guys. Interesting. I'll share this with you. I got an email from someone. I don't know who it is, who the person is. And they wrote me and said that they said, we are the light workers. And, like it was like, we are here to do a job. And then they said, look into James Wanless and look into the Voyager Tarot. And so I'm like, okay. So I followed that. I ordered them. The cards are amazing. I'm not using them tonight. I'm going to use the Rider-Waite deck for you tonight, but I am going to use those. Those cards are unbelievable and so revealing. If you've ever heard of the Voyager Tarot, if you've ever used them, let me know down in the comments and what you think about them. They just are speaking to me left and right. But tonight, I got three questions I want to know the answer to. First of all, we know that Lindsey Graham called the Secretary of State of the elections in Georgia to tell him to toss out ballots, legal ballots, until that Secretary of State came forward and spoke on it. After he spoke to counsel, by the way, he didn't just randomly speak on it. He had a telephone conversation with Lindsey, told Lindsey he could back with him, spoke to counsel, and then he told what was going on. Good for him. Bravo for him. He's a Republican, by the way, but he's living by, the law, what's supposed to happen in his particular state as it comes to elections and ballots. Then I want to know, is Biden going to hold anybody accountable? I know that Biden's plate is so full, and I just want to know, is he going to hold anyone accountable? Trump's administration, Trump maybe, Graham, that's election fraud, period. And then I want to know, I did a reading last night with a wonderful lady, and she was telling me that her thought was that during the holiday season, like Harris and Biden would be more or less quarantined, just kind of locked away before the inauguration, and at that time, Trump would go down to Mar-a-Lago and then make an escape. And so I just want to see if that's true. So that's what I'm looking at tonight. Hope everyone is having a wonderful evening, wonderful morning, afternoon, at whatever time that you see this particular video. I was busy today. I was cleaning chitlins or chitterlings, if you know what that is. If you don't know what that is, those are hog intestines, pig intestines that that's eaten well everywhere now. It's from the south, and you clean them and you cook them, boil them for a long time, and they're quite delicious actually. So my husband loves it for Thanksgiving. So I clean a couple of buckets. I do the old red bucket, clean them really well, and then I'll do the next bucket probably tomorrow. And there we go. So I was doing that today. So I'm in my chit, we call it chitlins in the black community. We don't say chitterlings, but the chitlins. I was cleaning them in my cleaning outfit. So there's that. Anyways, I'm a country girl. I really am. So let's take a look at Lindsey Graham, because now he's backtracking and now he's coming public saying that Trump should help with the transition and concede and all of that. And we know that it's BS. He's trying to cover his own tracks and trying to look like he's a real good guy when we already know what you're about. So I want to take a look at that. Give me just a minute to invoke my cards. Funny, the first card came up, tells me, yeah, he's trying to get out of hot water. Six of Swords, baby. Six of Swords. He's trying to get from the bad waters to the good waters. This is mentally, okay? He's trying to really like heal self, trying to appear to us, you know, trying to play mind games with us like he really cares. But if he cared so much, he would never have called down to Georgia. What in the heck is you do? What are you doing calling down to Georgia in the first place? But that's the energy of the reading. So we know he's trying to escape the situation he's putting himself into. What is it, Graham, backtracking now? Have you heard of chitterlings? Let me know if you know about that red bucket. They've got the already clean ones, and you guys that know about chitterlings know that the already clean are already dirty, so they're not, there's no such thing. Why is Lindsay trying to change his tune? You know, the first came to bipolar. That's what came to my mind right away. Boom, bipolar. A snake. Yeah, a snake. One more time. Why is Lindsey Graham changing his tune? Well, first of all, he needs help in more ways than one, quite frankly. But whatever money, whatever gifts, whatever abundance, whatever was supposed to be coming to him isn't coming to him. I think they made some kind of promise and agreement to him, because Trump is always negotiating. Keep that in mind. He's still, I'm going to do my quote fingers, a businessman. So I think they were negotiating something, and now that is not coming through to him. He's got a lot of hope. He's got the star card. He's hoping to get out of this. He's hoping to find himself back in a positive position, an upright position. He wants us to see him that way. He's trying to clear his consciousness. He's trying to make it seem as if I just did regular, you know, I did something. I was curious. I was just wondering. I was being thorough, when they didn't need his help down in Georgia for that. And he's got hope that we will buy that. Government will buy that, whatever the case may be. Then we have, of course, the Devil card. So to me, for him, he is totally addicted to power, oppression, call. That's what he was trying to do with that Secretary of State, oppress him, okay? Give him pressure and make him the votes go the way they wanted them to go. But he couldn't give him that pressure, and he's under pressure. Here you have this person. That would be Trump, government, McConnell, whoever, with not a lot of information about the people, especially those in Atlanta. And he lit up his tail, got him fired up, and he went and he acted. But the thing is, he's an adult, so there's that. And then we've got the Knight of Pentacles. It's saying that he better move very slow and cautiously. Very slow, very cautiously. It's showing him as definitely being oppressed as this Capricorn individual would be. I wonder when his birthday is. I don't know his birthday off the top of my head. So Lindsay is actually a Capricorn. Ah, the water. But he's actually a Capricorn. But he's making real slow, dumb moves. And then he's got this kind of energy, like, are you slow? Are you dumb? Do you know any better? Are you willing to take this money that was supposed to come to you for doing this particular task because it's not coming? Or if it's coming real slow. Whatever promises of abundance and power, or I'm going to move you up, that's coming very slowly if it comes at all. And actually, he's got the Four of Wands in reverse. So whatever he was offered that was going to come to him, that's going to offer him stability and come slowly, it's not coming at all. So why is he backtracking? He wants to get himself out of trouble. Okay, so he's seeking to get into better, calmer water. Why? Whatever monies were coming to him are now not coming. This negotiation blew up. It blew up probably because all the news about him hit what he did, hit the news. So they had to stop what they were doing. This money was coming slow anyways, if it was coming at all. And so now it's not coming. Now he's trying to paint himself to say, I hope they see me as this good person, that I really am about the planet and the universe and positivity and blessings, that I'm here to heal and soothe. And, you know, I want to be that good Cancer, loving all people, taking care of people. When actuality, he is an oppressor. He's an oppressor. He is under pressure. He tried to put pressure on the Georgia Secretary of State of the elections. You are an oppressor. You are addicted to power. You can't even think clearly. Everything you think of is black and dirty, sooty. How can you get ahead? What can you do that's in the dark? He likes to do things in the dark, and it came to the light, as the things do. And ultimately, this is going to be a fail for him. He still will find himself in hot water. Let me tell you something. You guys ever notice anybody that tries to do things for Trump always gets busted? Always. The rap singer Lil Wayne was telling people in the black community he was going to vote for Trump, right? This is a little bit before the election. And he just got arrested for, or charged, or investigated by the FBI for arms and ammo. Sure did. But he hadn't been in any trouble prior to that, not in a very long time. And now this is what happens to him. My daughter made me some lemonade. Okay, let's take a look at Biden. Will Biden hold Trump, Graham, McConnell, or anybody accountable? Will he hold the former, any Republicans, the administration, will he hold anyone accountable for their wrongdoings? Will Biden, Joe Biden, hold anyone accountable for their wrongdoings? Will Biden hold anyone accountable for their wrongdoings? Will Biden hold anyone accountable for their wrongdoings? That's my only thing, guys, with Democrats. You know what? And they're not perfect. They do dirt too, trust me. But at the same time, they never want to take the role that says, we have a right to charge you. We have the right to hold you accountable. I don't understand it, but Republicans will do that to them in a New York minute, and they should be doing the same. Biden has the top job in our country. That to me seems like that's what he's supposed to do with his new DOJ. And you know, Bill Barr has been real quiet. Real quiet. Will Biden be holding anyone accountable for their crimes and wrongdoings in the Republican administration? Will Biden be holding anyone accountable in the Republican administration for wrongdoings? No, I don't see it. I see, first of all, there's so much coming at Biden right now so fast. With first of all, he can't even get his get the transition papers. He can't even get the COVID plan. He can't get anything, okay? But things are coming at him very quickly, and he's trying to move quickly, his own self trying to get his own cabinet together. So that's the first thing. He's got the Nine of Swords. I'm sorry to hear that, but that's inevitable. You're coming into a time where this country was turned upside down on their ear, and he is super stressed, anxious, losing sleep, worrying about how to bring the country back together, how to get the economy up and going, how to get on top of this COVID, you know, how to get the schools open, get people working again. He's got the Queen of Cup energy, Scorpio dude. He knows what's going on. It doesn't matter about gender. But he knows everything. He sees it. Look at that. He sees everything. She's the only one that sits with that magical cup in her hand that she can look into it. And that tells me he knows what they have done. He is not a fool, been a long time government person. He knows what they've done, right or wrong. He is very intuitive. He knows when people are going to be coming up on him with BS and all of that. He does know. He's very clear. He's not confused, but he's torn. Like, do I go after them or do I have take care of everything else? And he's looking at all the things that he has to do going on for him, coming up, coming down the road, stuff that's just thrown at him. And I almost get it because they won't even give him the ability to transition, and Trump won't sit down and even have a conversation with him. He's so busy protecting his ego. So he's got to jump in there running. And so even though he sees what's going on, I think that he's just going to be too weighed down with too much. He's going to have a lot of responsibilities, a lot of burdens. Everybody's going to want something from him. He's going to get beat up a lot. He's got a lot of getting beat up, but he's going to be able to handle it. He will be able to handle it. He knows better than we do, or better than I do, what it was like being the vice president to the first black president of the United States. So he knows the racism and the hate and the parties in the Senate that are Republican parties and those people that want to push against him. But he's going to keep pushing. He's going to push through. He's not going to make that his focus, though. He's not going to make their crimes their focus. He's not. He wants to get this country back stable again. This is what we want. This is what we all want. We want to be infused with new, fresh energy, a lot of energy in this country. We want this country to be back on top. We want it to be lush, green, prosperous, stable, opportunities, jobs, money flowing again. And that's what he's going to be really burdened down with. So if you're waiting on him to, you know, have a whole big bunch of people arresting people, and I'm telling you, no, date this video. You remember I told you that? No, he's not going to do that. He's not going to have the time to do that. I get it. You know, I'm a grown up. I get it. And then lastly, I just want to look at what Bev, what's her name is Bev, very nice lady. And I think she watches Bev and Cheryl. Hi Bev, hi Cheryl. But she was talking about her theory. And I want to see, is Trump going to escape? Is he going to escape within the next 30 days? Will Trump try to escape within the next 30 days? Guys, is it just me, or have you noticed that Trump's hair used to be this pissy, yellowish, dirty hair? Like, you know, when here when you smoke cigarettes and stuff, and your hair is white, it gets this yellowy, and now it's white as snow. Like, what? I guess he stopped dyeing it. He said, "What the heck? I don't care no more." Is Trump going to attempt to escape in the next 30 days? Guys, please show me. Is Trump going to attempt to escape in the next 30 days? Is he going to attempt to escape? Wouldn't it be funny if that's exactly what he's planning? I mean, it really would be with all this talk of him winning and all this, because he's always been, the whole time, he's been about distractions, distractions, distractions. And now all of a sudden he's distracting us. We're looking this way about him, admitting or not admitting he lost, won, however way you want to look at, and then he disappears. First of all, I see that he is really in his feelings. This is a guy that has really gotten beat up with those last 4 years. Somebody who lost something that he didn't really want to begin with. And usually it should be like this. You take a licking and you keep on ticking. I think that was Timex watch. Yeah. So he's taking a beat down and he can't handle it. But that's how bullies are. They can't handle it. He doesn't want to go back to whatever his old life was, that whole New York Trump Tower living it up thing. He doesn't want to go there. Usually this is people that are hunger for nostalgia. No matter how good or bad it was, they want to go back, and he does not want to go back. Why doesn't he want to go back? Bum 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 bum. Yeah. This very severe number five staring him in the face. A lot of harsh tests coming for him, a lot of trials and tribulations coming for him, a lot of things that he's messed up. I think he had this in the last reading. He's very isolated. He's very depressed. He's by himself. Like, he's not even really seeing people. It's almost if I can almost see Ivanka checking on him. Daddy, are you okay? Are you okay? Melania is not really having anything to do with him. And he's isolated. And if you see him walking around, he looks like this. His head is down, slumped over, depressed, in the dark, disappointed. Can't see anything good out of what happened. Not willing to congratulate somebody else because you're too concerned about yourself, and not wanting to go back to New York. But will he escape? Doesn't want it to be over. This is the world in reverse. This is, you have everything going for you. You can start all over again. He has nothing going for him. He absolutely has nothing going for him. He can't even make nothing. Man, is this guy, what? Let me look at these cards. Oh, okay. So we got him not being able to stand the heat. Okay, he got beat pretty doggone good. He thought he was going to do even better. That was going to be this landslide, and it hurt him in every possible way. Rather than being, he's a just a very sore loser, very immature. Not wanting to go back to that old New York life and whatever he was doing. Why? Because he knows it's not good for him. It's not going to be good for him. There's nothing good coming out of it for him. Things are over for him. Not only this presidential election, but he is going to face a lot of legal issues, and it's over. It's the world card in reverse, and that means, like, you don't have everything going for you. You don't have the flow of energy. You didn't learn anything. You can't even begin over because you never learned anything to begin with. He's got the magician card. That means he can't. This is a Gemini card. He should be this able to play games and to think his way out of anything and tell you what you want to hear. He has nowhere to go. It's like he hit a brick wall. You know what I mean? Like, he hit a brick wall and he doesn't even know how to get out of it. And he's got the sun card, because that says that we all see you. We see you now. We see who you are. Those that want to see him, let me put it like that. This energy of illumination on everything that he is doing. Yes. He's making plans to escape. He wants out. He is looking overseas. He has not picked one place because one place has not picked him. I don't know if he's in the midst of talking to people, but he's definitely planning. So I promise you that he is making plans to leave, and he probably will leave. This is planning. He's fired up about it. This is looking across the globe. Where is a place he can go away from here? This is like our shores and then going across the shores. Okay. And ultimately, if he goes someplace else, he wants to go someplace else, but he's going to feel like I'm the celebrated one. Like, we hate him over here, but over there, they actually love him. So yes, he is planning to escape. Yeah, he's even having conversations. He's talking to people, Page of Wands. He's talking to people about escaping. And that's him. This is actually him walking away. This is him being beat. Okay. This is not him. This is not him bullying. This is Biden taking those votes back from him. Even if they do a recount, it's going to turn out to be the same. And he and his children and all that clan has to go away. So is he planning to escape? Yes, he is. Where he's going to escape, it's going to be somewhere overseas. He is going to go away. He won't be at that. I don't see him being at the inauguration for sure. So anyways, guys, that is my reading for the, that's my questions. I thought I'd bring you into it. The next time I do a reading, I'm going to do the Voyager card. Man, these are really a 21st deck. Like, these are very an archaic deck where we still have leprosy. Like, he has leprosy. He's got the leper's bell on and extreme poverty. And you've got the pages and the knights and things like that. And I love this deck, believe me. But this deck is really an amazing deck. Gonna kind of blow your mind a little bit when you see it. It's the Voyager deck. But guys, thank you so much. This is Joyce. Subscribe, thumbs up. Oh my goodness, we hit 11,000. Did you see that? Ah, I'm shocked. Good night, guys. Have a good night.